Once again, welcome you to this Literacy 2 lesson, which is almost the last about leadership in our sub-county. I remember talking about different types of leaders. We talked about elected leaders and civic leaders and every other type of leaders we talked about in the past lessons or in the previous lessons. Now, I want us to talk about the civic leaders. Civic leaders are leaders who are just appointed by people who have authority to serve at the district, at the sub-county. In this country, majorly, they are those who are appointed by the president, especially. But even others can be appointed by service commissions and so on. But then, I want us to look at some of them, the ones we have in our sub-county and in our district at large. For example, we have the DEO. DEO in full is District Education Officer. Again, District Education Officer. We have CAO, Chief Administrative Officer. Chief Administrative Officer. We have RDC. I think you've heard of this guy here several times during this COVID-19 pandemic. The RDCs are the ones who have been in control or trying to manage the task force to control the COVID-19. RDC in full is Resident District Commissioner. Resident District Commissioner. We have the DIS. This is District Inspector of Schools, the one who inspects, the one who supervises schools. District Inspector of Schools. We have DPC. Most of you know this one. District Police Commander. District Police Commander. We have the DPO, this is a District Probation Officer. This one is in charge of children's affairs at the district. The DPC is the one who heads actually the police in the district. The DIS is in charge of supervising schools. RDC is the head of security in the district. Is the head of security in the district. CAO is the head of all civil servants in the district. All workers in the district are headed by the CAO and others. I want to talk about the political leaders. Political leaders are sometimes referred to as elected leaders. Why do we refer to them as elected leaders? They are elected because they get into leadership through voting, which we are calling elections. So they are referred to as elected leaders because they get leadership through elections. So examples of those leaders whom we elect, we have chairpersons, right from chairperson LOC1 up to chairperson LOC5. That's chairperson LOC1 in your village, LOC2, LOC3, LOC4, and LOC5, which is a district. We have the president. You all know that for you to become a president in Uganda today, leave alone those days where they used to go to the bush. These days, you have to go for elections. When Ugandans vote for you, you become the president. We have member of parliament. Most of you know also what an MP is. So, members of parliament also are elected. Mayor, councillors, all those are elected leaders. We have the local council one. This is our village. The village council. Local council 1 or LOC 1 is a committee that is made up of 10 members. These members are also elected either by ballot or standing by them behind to vote for them anyway, like the last time we voted by open election, we were making lines. So these 10 members are also elected. They are voted for so that they start ruling or they start to govern or to guide our village. We have 10 of them, but we are going to look at some of them, especially in the next lesson here. But before we go to the individuals of the 10 members, here I have the duties of a local council. What are the duties of a local council? They settle disputes. I remember explaining what we mean by settling disputes. When people have problems in the village, it is the local council to come in and settle disputes among these people in the village to maintain law and order. They maintain law and order through the 10 members. If you commit a crime, you shall be reported to the LC1, and in doing so, they are maintaining law and order. They promote security through the Secretary for Security. When you commit a crime, they will send for the Secretary of Security to come for you, and you're presented before the local council 1 committee. They promote peace. This is self-explanatory, that they promote peace in the area because it requires the village to be at peace in order to develop, in order to avoid disputes, in order to have law and order. They mobilize people. I think very many of you, you've been hearing in this pandemic when the LC1 chairpersons, they are the ones telling people who are coming to their village when they are unknown, telling them to the government because they were worried of the pandemic, exposing them to the government so that they check them before. So that was mobilizing. LC1s can mobilize people towards government programs, like the one you've been having, the task force for COVID-19. LC1s, chairpersons, it and the rear members have done it after the rest for this time. Here, I have some of the members for this lesson. We shall continue looking at more other members, but here I've brought three members who are the most important to look at for today. We have the chairperson. The chairperson is the head of the whole village, of the village, which we are referring to as local council 1. What are the roles of the chairperson? The chairperson chairs meetings. What do you mean by chairing meetings? He's the head of the village. So for any meeting, he's the one who presides over the meeting. He's the one who chairs the meeting for it to take place. And so that the village is at par with what the discussion may be. He heads the village. I've already said this. He heads the village. He signs official documents. Like if you want to open up an account in the bank, you should have a letter from the chairperson, LC1. So he should sign for you. If you're going to get a passport to go abroad, you should have a letter from the chairperson, LC1. That's the role, signing official documents. It's a role and it's very important. You need your chairperson, LC1. Actually, some people refer to him as the president of the village, and they're right. We have the vice chairperson. The vice chairperson is functional or is so important when the chairperson is not there. However, he assists the chairperson in all these other duties without forgetting his main role at the village is to be in charge of children's affairs. Children's affairs. What do you mean by this? In case of any problem to children, you have been abused in any form, do not run anyway. Run to your chairperson, LC1. He's the one who's going to handle your issue up to the police and to the courts of law. We have the general secretary. The general secretary is the person who is in charge of recording minutes. What do you mean by minutes? All proceedings, all what takes place during the village meetings, it is the secretary who writes down. And whatever he writes down is what we are referring to as minutes. He keeps records of the LC. What do you mean by records? It can be the stamp of the LC. It can be the documents of the LC. It can be agreements, copies of agreements of the LC with other parties. So it is the general secretary that keeps records of the whole village. To prepare documents for the chairman to sign, like the ones I've talked about, a letter showing you to the bank in order to open the account, it is the secretary who writes it, then it is given to the chairperson to sign it. And so that you can go on and do what you intended to do. So we shall look at other members of the LC1 council, and we shall continue to understand them. But for today, I'd like to end here, and I have a few numbers here that I would like you to try out for me. Thank you for learning. We wish you the best. Stay safe. Continue to sanitize. Keep a social distance. And wash your hands regularly. I'm Teacher Ezekiel.